Hello, this is Mark Warren and I'm back with another vision restoration video, and today I want to talk about something for you to think about, and I'm sure I'm going to have some comments because it's probably going to be a little controversial for those doing other vision restoration methods. And I want to talk about active focus. I'm now believing that active focus isn't something that you can control. You can't control the focus on your eyes. And hear me out on this. The reason why I say this is because when I get crystal clear clarity and my eyes just start focusing on their own, I'm not doing anything. I'm not trying to see sharp. I'm not trying to see clear. It just happens. I mean, I can look at something close, it's clear. I can look at something farther away, it clears. I'm not doing anything to get that. And I'm suspecting that that is a completely involuntary thing. We have no control over it. I think it's more like the heartbeat. Our heartbeat goes boom, 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 boom. And we can't control our heartbeat rhythm. We can influence our heartbeat to beat faster with exercise or slower with meditation and rest. But we can't control that heartbeat itself. That's controlled by some function in the brain. And I have a feeling that the focusing in the eyes is also something that's controlled in the brain. So there's two parts to active focus. For those doing other methods of vision restoration, when you subconsciously become aware of your peripheral, your eyes will automatically start focusing on their own. And that's what most people are calling active focus. But it's that subconscious awareness of your peripheral. And what I believe happens to a lot of people is they're subconsciously aware and they get some improvement, but then they get to a point where they stall and there's no more progress. And that's only because they can, again, subconsciously, they notice more stuff outside their central vision, but they don't get any more progress. And that's where the second part of focusing comes in. You have to be aware of movement between multiple objects. It's that shifting space and separation that keeps our ciliary muscles stimulated so the brain can go to work and focus the lens properly. So I'm no longer really going to call it active focus. I'm going to call it automatic focus, because when I give my eyes the stimulus that it needs by noticing the peripheral and noticing movement between objects, whether I'm sitting still and stationary and just turning my head, or if I'm walking and moving, or, you know, in a vehicle or something like that, the focus is automatic. It's nothing that I'm trying to do. I'm not forcing it or anything. It's just completely automatic. So just something to think about. And again, I know I'm probably going to get blasted by other people. You don't know what you're talking about. Well, okay. But that's just what I'm feeling on this. Like I said, everybody's like, well, you must be really good at active focus. No, I'm just giving my brain all the information that it needs to focus the lens properly, control that ciliary muscle to focus that lens properly. So short video, but hope you enjoyed it and stay tuned. We'll catch you on the next one.